Hello all, I'm Dr. M. Sudhakar Rao, Consultant Cardiologist, Manipal Hospital, Sarjapur Road. Today, I'm going to discuss about imaging-guided coronary angioplasty. Over the last few decades, improvement in stents, techniques, procedures, equipments, and pharmaceutical therapy has caused both the short-term and long-term clinical outcomes to improve in the patients. One such improvisation is the use of imaging in coronary angioplasty. The traditionally used coronary angioplasty has its own limitations. It cannot assess the physiologically important blocks. It can cause increased complications during the procedure. It cause suboptimal outcomes and cause increased event rates and increase the hospitalization stay of the patients. So what is imaging we are talking about? Imaging, that is the use of intravascular ultrasound, it sees the inner walls of the arteries. It can either be IVUS, that is the intravascular ultrasound, which is based on the principle of sound, or the optimal coherence tomography, which is based on the principle of light. OCT has a better spatial resolution, better penetration, and gives good quality of images. Why we should do imaging in our angioplasties? Imaging improves the accuracy of the results. It improves both the short-term and long-term outcomes. It decreases the complication rate during the procedure, and also it decreases the hospitalization rates. Should we do imaging in all our angioplasties? Ideally, yes. But in our country, because of the cost effectiveness, we cannot do so. And so, in a limited group of patients, we ideally should do imaging. And this includes stent failure, where a person comes with repeated blocks within the stent, or in case of left main lesions, or in cases of bifurcation angioplasties, in severely calcific lesions, where imaging makes a difference in the outcomes, and also it tells what therapy we should use for the calcium, and in ambiguous lesions where to stent or not is an important factor. Apart from the imaging, one more physiological assessment is important, which is the use of FFR or RFR or IFR. The most common being used is the FFR, which is the fractional flow reserve. So what is the FFR? An FFR is just a pressure wire which is put across a blockage in a borderline lesions where somebody has a 50 or 70% of blockage to decide whether the block needs a stent or not. It sees the pressure difference across the block and takes a call. Why FFR is important? Because it alleviates the need of unnecessary stenting, and also it improves the long-term outcomes of the patient. In many studies, the FFR has been shown better or superior over the use of conventional angioplasty for stenting.